Hi everybody, today I want to show you a new product, or at least it was that for me. I saw Janet over at Monkey Island Madness painting with these. It's the Graphitint Paint Pan Set. Now the Graphitints are not new because we already have them in pencil form, and I have the complete 24 set. The colors are muted and I love them, and I have used them some, not as much as I want to, or I wish that I did, but there are all the 24 colors that the pencils comes in. But now they actually have made a pan set of it, and I was like, yeah! Because one of the reasons that I really haven't used my pencils as much is because if I want to use watercolors, I would rather use watercolors. But I have had to kind of make or turn my pencils into watercolors. Now pencils are usually just used for the details and add-ons when I actually want to watercolor. Now I do use watercolor pencils in the coloring books and stuff, and just use them as pencil and then dilute them, but when I'm painting I kind of would want to use them as paint. But I really love the Graphitint colors, so I haven't then used or turned my pencils into watercolors. With this set I no longer have to, because it actually comes in a travel set. It says Graphitint Paint Pan Pocket Set 12 pans. We have some info on the back here. By the Derwent Art, made in Graphitint. So I just put that box up there. So let's just dive into it. I have just removed the plastic that was around it. So this is the color chart that comes with it, Graphitint Paint Pan Pocket Set. We get Autumn Baron, Russet, Maslow, I think, and Green Gray, Slate Green, Ocean Blue, Steel Blue, Dark Indigo, Aubergine, Juniper, that is Port, and Graphite Gray. So. But I kind of want to, or I like to swatch them out myself, so I have cut out this little pamphlet thing there. So I want to swatch them myself and to see the colors. I haven't checked if these colors are, or if there are any new colors or not. But I have some two small water containers. And a little brush. Don't quite get the order these are in, but anyways, when I swatch this out, I think that I want to speed this up so you can enjoy some music and stuff while I'm at it. Thank you. me swatch out do this two times. First I did it in the order that my tin came in. Not really happy with that order, so I will rearrange them myself. And with this tin, it's quite easy to actually do that. So, what do we have here? I want to have. I should. Yeah, I'll just. Come on. I need something to pick them up with. I guess. Do I have something over here? I do. So that is the metal. That was, oh, they are in the pan. I don't have to take. Come on. Come on. That pan was quite hard. Oh my god. Seriously? Well, okay. I will just leave that then. But I will just pick up only the blocks itself. Oops. Come on. My god, these ones are soft. They're coming stuff off them when I'm picking them up. Maybe this wasn't that good idea after all. Come on. Here we have that bottom color. This was the blue slate. And that was the juniper. And here we can I, yeah. Come on. Okay. Oh, there. I can get them out when, yeah, like that. I just have to push them real hard. Like that. And that. And that. And, well. Come on. Yeah. Like that. Yes, yes, yes. Now this is working. Oh, come on. Like that, so I don't have to take them out of the pan. Oh my god. These pants really sure was set snug and tight in there. And I guess that is a good thing, really. Clean that one. I'm sorry for fiddling so much, but like that. But I do like to have my paints in the order that I want to have them in. So like that. So let's pick up the metal, put that on there, then the russet next to it. So kind of goes from yellow green. And further on, the autumn brown I would like to have. Then the port one. That's actually quite beautiful color, and it granulates, or it looks like it. Of the port, I want juniper. Let's put that in there. And that aubergine is one of my favorite colors ever. I think it's gorgeous. Slate green, I want to have down there. And then the ocean blue next to it. And my gray-green, green-gray, whatever it's called. And then I want the, oh, the steel blue next to that. I want that blue, come on, to be with the blues, like that. And then that steel blue there, and that there. Then I have that indigo and that graphite gray there, like that. Now, push, squeeze them down so they snug and tight so they don't fall out. Yeah, like that. So then I'll just put that this to the side. So there is my swatches. So They really, really, really beautiful. I probably won't be using this one because this one looks like it's the same one that we got in the Inktense set, or this is this set too. Yeah, it looks like, yeah, that is the same one. So we are getting a Derwent Water Badger. That one was quite thick. I don't know if it's they are different sizes or it's just the same size. Well, that is brand new while I actually have used that one, tested it out. Yeah, so. But, yeah. So this is how I arrange my colors. Now if you see these colors, now you can see that, oh come on camera, oh seriously, you see that beautiful porch color there, it looks like it's granulating a little bit. Oh my god, what is wrong with my stupid camera? And my pen actually bled, so that was not waterproof even if it said that it was supposed to be it. But look at these muted tones, they are so beautiful. Oh my god. So I think that I should actually test them out by actually painting something. I have this cheap paper, or I don't actually know if it's cheap or not, Aquarelle Etival watercolor pad that I got from the last Garola box. So just ripped out a page from that. So I will paint with them and actually test them out. Oh my god, for real. So you can listen to some music again while I paint and yeah, and do my thing. Thank you. So now we are at my, or one of my favorite parts with paintings. It's time to remove the tape. So let's see what we ended up with. I do like that they leave it easily. I did not have any problems with that. Of course I like the muted colors. Now I have I use them quite watered down, so there, now I will pick it up so you can see what we managed to do in this little test. Yeah, I really love these colors. I think that it's going to be so much fun watercoloring with them. And for a landscape palette, I do wish we could have a different green, like a more green, because I have the ivy color now. The meadow is greenish as well, but I don't know, would like to have something more green, and of course something more brown as well, because there's that autumn brown that I kind of there put down there in that little boat. If my camera can, there you can, oh my god, camera, can you find it if I put my finger on it? Oh, this stupid camera. Anyway, my little boat there is in that autumn brown, but it is actually more red than brown, really. So if I add myself like one vibrant green and one brown, then I can manage very well with this set. No, that is not something that you have to do. That is just my preferences and for what I usually paint. So, but I really like the colors that comes with this set, and the granulating that is happening in like the aubergine. It is very pretty. Now, that didn't show on this paper because this is cellulose paper. So, and it is fine. So it's not textured at all, so yeah, that is why. Anyway, that was it. I think I have said what I want to say. Just wiping some of this off for close it up. Of course I will have to laminate my swatch sheet there. Yeah, something like that. Can just put that in there. For that sponge over there, what I'm using it for, like when I'm out and about and painting and I don't have my rag. Now I usually always have my rag, but I'm using that sponge to clean off my my brush, like when I'm picking up colors and I have too much water, I'm just dabbing some off there and then I can go on and paint. So that is what that sponge is there for, or I don't know if that's why, but that's what I'm using it for. Yeah. So I will try to link to Janet's channel, Monkey Island Madness, where I first saw these amazing graphitint watercolor paint pan set. So thank you, Janet, for showing us these. I really love them. And to everybody else, thank you so much for watching, and I hope that you all stay safe and that you take care, and I love you all. Bye.